Hello everyone, in this tutorial I'll show you how you can make this granny shoulder bag. Let's go started! I made this bag with two colors yarn. That's an acrylic yarn, a cheap acrylic yarn. One ball has multicolors, and then we have this yarn with those really soft pompons. If you want this bag without the pompons, then remove those pompons and you work only with that yarn. The crochet that I'm use is in 4 mm. Change from color how many as you want. You can choose also to make this bag in one color. I start with the first color with a magic circle. And then we make and chain 3. 1, 2, 3, and this counts for a first double crochet. In that magic circle you make 3 double crochets. That's 1, 2, and 3. Now we have here in with the beginning of that chain 3, 4 double crochets in that magic circle. We make a corner and chain 2, 1 and 2, and then in the magic circle you'll make 4 double crochets. That's 1, 2, 3 and 4. A new corner and chain 2, 1 and 2, back in that same magic circle with 4 double crochets. That's 1, 2, 3 and 4. Make a chain 2 for a new corner and 4 double crochets in that same magic circle. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now we make our last corner, chain 2, then we close that magic ring, pull on that short little thread here, and the ring is closed. And we work a slip stitch in the third chain stitch here in the beginning. 1, 2, and 3 in that stitch. You work a slip stitch. Grab your yarn, pull through, and pull through. Now we have here a little square. I start with the same color. We make a chain 3. 1, 2, and 3. This counts for a first double crochet. In the next 3 stitches, on the top of the next 3 double crochets, we work a new double crochet. That's 1, into the next stitch, 2, and in the next stitch, 3. Now we have here 4 double crochets. In that chain 2 corner space, we make a new corner. 2 double crochets in that corner space, 1, and 2. Make a chain 2, 1 and 2, and go back in that same chain 2 corner space with another 2 double crochets. That's 1, back in that same space, 2 for a new corner. Now we have to make a straight side. In the next 4 stitches we make a new double crochet. That's 1, into the next stitch, 2, and in the next, 3, and in the next, 4, and in the next chain 2 corner space we make a new corner of 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, make a chain 2, and 2 double crochets in that same corner space. So you work all the way around. In the next 4 stitches, a double crochet. And then in the next chain 2 corner space, a new corner of 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 double crochets, and in the next 4 stitches, 1 double crochet, and then in the last corner here, 2 double crochets, a chain 2 and 2 double crochets in that same space for a new corner. And now we all the way around and we make a slip stitch in the beginning. That's that chain 3 space. The chain 3 counts for a double crochet. 1, 2, 3 in that third stitch. Go in with your hook, grab your yarn, pull through and pull through for a slip stitch. I start with the same color. You can change from color as you want. We make a chain 3. Counts for a double crochet. And now we work in every stitch all the way around. 1 double crochet. And you work in every chain 2 corner space a new corner. In that space here, 2 double crochets. Chain 2 and 2 double crochets. And on the straight side you work in every stitch and double crochet. And your first stitch is here, that first double crochet after that chain 2 corner space. Don't forget that first stitch. That's the first of here of the straight side. And every stitch you work and double crochet. Work so all the way around and make in the beginning a slip stitch, and that's that chain 3 here in the beginning on the third stitch. I made my last corner here and now we have 2 stitches over. In every stitch we make a double crochet and a slip stitch in the beginning. Now we have here 3 rounds complete. We work 8 rounds in total. Make 5 more rounds on the same way. My last stitches. I'm done with round 8 and now we cut the yarn. And we make an invisible join here in the beginning. We pull up all the way up. And then with a needle, we make that invisible join in the first double crochet. Not here in that chain 3. We skip those chain 3. We go on the top of that first double crochet. From the front to the back. Only through that V-stitch, pull through, you go back to the last double crochet, only in the back loop of that whole stitch here on the top, and pull through. This is your invisible join here. And both tails we weave in on the back of our work. Now we have 8 rounds done and from corner to corner we have on one side 32 stitches. Count your stitches, on every side you make 32 stitches. I start with a color B and we make a slip knot on the hook. And we start in a corner chain 2 corner space. and we begin in the chain two corner space with a standing double crochet. We yarn over, enter your hook in that chain two corner space, grab your yarn, pull up, three loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over and pull through two for a standing double crochet. In that same chain two corner space, we make a double crochet and chain two and two double crochets in that same corner space. That's one and two for a new corner. Now we work on the next 13 stitches and double crochet. And your first stitches here in that first double crochet after that chain two. That's one. Next stitch. Two. In the next stitch. Three. Four. Five. Six. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and the last one, 13. Into the next two stitches, we work two double crochets together. We're going to decrease the stitches, yarn over, enter your hook in the next stitch and grab your yarn and pull up, yarn over and pull through two. Now we stop, yarn over, enter your hook in the next stitch, grab your yarn and pull up, yarn over and pull through two. Now we have two not complete double crochets on the hook and the last stitch. Three loops, yarn over and pull through three loops. Now we have here two double crochets together. We skip the next two stitches and then in the next two stitches we work also two double crochets together. Yarn over, skip two stitches, one and two, and go to the next stitch, grab your yarn, yarn over and pull through two. Yarn over, into the next stitch, grab your yarn, yarn over, pull through two, three loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through three loops. Now we have here decrease the stitches. In the corner we do increase stitches and here in the middle decrease stitches. Now in the next 13 stitches, we work a double crochet. That brings us to the next corner. That's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. Now in the next chain two corner space, we work a new corner. We increase the stitches, two double crochets in that corner space, chain two, and two double crochets in that same space. And now we start all over again. We repeat all those stitches here three more times. You work in the next 13 stitches a double crochet, then you work two double crochets together, skip two, chain stitches, two stitches, two double crochets together, 13 double crochets, and then a new corner. 13 double crochets, Then you work in the next two stitches, two double crochets together. Skip the next two stitches, in the next two stitches, two double crochets together. And 13 double crochets. And then in the next chain two corner space, two double crochets, chain two, and two double crochets in that same space. Also on, make on the next two sides also all your stitches. In the beginning, we work a slip stitch on the top of that first standing double crochet. We start with the next round and you can make and chain three for a double crochet, but you can start also a little bit different in the beginning. And I'll show you what I mean. I make a changeless starting double crochet. We pull up a loop to the high of a double crochet. Now you place your finger on the loop on your hook and we make go around that loop like this and you enter your hook in that same stitch where you make that slip stitch in the previous round. Then you grab your yarn and make a double crochet. And it looks like now a little bit more of a double crochet here in the beginning. I'll show you once more. You make a slip stitch here in the top of that standing double crochet to close this round. And now we start with a new round. Pull a loop about the high of a double crochet. Place your finger on the loop. Go with your hook around that loop and go into the stitch where you make that slip stitch. Grab your yarn, pull through. Now you have three loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. Into the next stitch and double crochet. And now you work two double crochets in that chain two corner space, that's one, two, and chain two, one and two double crochets in that same corner space, one and two for a new corner. And now we start all over again. We make 13 double crochets and then we make two double crochets together. Skip two stitches, two double crochets together, 13 double crochets. You start with 13 double crochets, that's one, two, three, And that's number 13. Now we make and two double crochet together in the next two double crochet stitches. That's one into the next stitch. That's two, yarn over and work together. Skip two stitches and in the next two stitches two double crochets together. That's one into the next stitch, two and together, and then in the next 13 stitches and double crochet. And then in the chain two corner space, two double crochets, chain two and two double crochets. Now you work all those stitches on the next three sides and work a slip stitchje on the top of that first double crochet here in the beginning. My last stitch, and now we work on the top of that first changeless starting double crochet a slip stitch, one, two, three, yes, pull through and pull through, and now we start all over again. Make a little loop. Make your first double crochet. Then in the next double, and in the next two doubles. And now we make a new corner. Two double crochets. Chain two. Two double crochets. And now we work on the same way that we did in the round before. And if you look at your work, then you see that we have also a little bit starting off and back. Go so on, work three more rounds on the same way that you did before. Three more rounds to go, and we have then five rounds, and then I change from color, and then we make also the next round with the pom-poms yarn. Five rounds complete, and I cut the yarn and pull up that yarn, and I make in the beginning an invisible join. Not in that first changeless starting double crochet, but in the next double crochet. And then only in the back loop of that last double crochet and pull through. I have color A on the hook, and now we work also around with the pom-pom yarn. We start with a standing double crochet in a corner space, in a chain two corner space. Now we grab the pom-pom yarn and put it on your work here in the corner, and work a double crochet in that same chain 2 corner space. Make a chain 2 and 2 double crochets in that same corner space. That's one. And it's a little bit tricky to work with that pom-pom yarn. One more double crochet to go. Like this. This is your new corner. 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 double crochets. Now we work on the next 13 stitches and double crochet. The first double crochet is here after that chain 2 corner space, and we work also around that pom-pom. Like this. Go around that pom-pom. That's one. Into the next stitch. Two. In the next stitch. Work around that pom-pom. And three. In the next stitch. It's difficult to see. One, two, three. And the next stitch, that's 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now we work also around that pom-pom. 9. Ten, 11, 12, and 13. You see here both pom-poms. You can pull up a little bit higher. Also this one. Like this. Now we work 2 double crochets together in the next 2 stitches. That's 1 and 2 and together. Skip 2 stitches, 1, 2, and then in the next 2 stitches, 2 double crochets together. And then 13 double crochets to the next corner. It's 11, 12, and 13. And then you make a new corner. 2 double crochets, chain 2, 2 double crochets. Work so all the way around, work all your pom-poms, and then close with a slip stitch here in the beginning, and then we cut the yarn of the pom-poms, and then we work further with color A. And that's it. Go so on and on and change from color so many as you want. I made 14 rows and I cut the yarn, and in the beginning I make an invisible join. Only what we have to do is now we're making 2 handles. No colors on my hook, and we attach that yarn here in that point, in that corner space, chain 2 corner space, with a standing single crochet. Now we work chain stitches, 80 in total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, and work very loosely. 11, 12, 13, 14, and that's number 80. Now we go to the next point here and we make a single crochet. Make a chain stitch and make a little knot, and we cut the yarn. Now we have this, and we work that also to the other side 2 times. The color is back on my hook, and we start with a standing single crochet in the last double crochet here for that chain 2 space. Standing single crochet. Now we work in each chain stitch a single crochet, and we place both little pieces of thread on the back of our work, and we work also around both tails. And every chain stitch a single crochet, 80 in total. The last stitches, 2 more to go, and that's number 80. We make all the way around single crochets. The next stitch we make in that chain 2 space. Make a single crochet, and now we work in each stitch on the top of each double crochet also a single crochet, and we place also that little piece of thread here on the back of our work, and we work over it. And now we're at the point where we make 2 times 2 double crochets together. We work 2 single crochets together on the top of that first 2 double crochet together. Go in with your hook and grab your yarn and pull up. Go to the next stitch, and that's the second 2 double crochets together. Go in with your hook, grab your yarn, pull up, 3 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through. 3 loops. And now go further with in every stitch making a single crochet. Work so all the way around on each next 80 chain stitches also a single crochet, and the last single crochet here we make that 4 where we make the attached yarn for the single crochets, we make also a single crochet and then 80 single crochets in the chain stitches and in the next space of the two single chain stitches we work also a single crochet and then in every stitch a single crochet, and the point where we make two times two double crochets together, we make in each stitch up the top of the two double crochets together two single crochets together. Two stitches to go for the second handle. We work also in that chain two space a single crochet, and now we work on each chain stitch also a single crochet. And that little tail goes on the back of the stitches. In each chain stitch, a single crochet. And we make one more single crochet here in the chain two space, and then in every stitch a single crochet. And then in the point where we make two times two double crochets together, we work two single crochets together. That's one, into the next stitch, two, and work together. And then in every stitch, a single crochet. There, the beginning, and then we close with a slip stitch in the first stitch here. Make a slip stitch. We start with the next round. Chain stitch, and then in the same stitch we make a single crochet, and then in every stitch all the way around a single crochet. And if you get by the point where we make two single crochets together, also in those two stitches two single crochets together. Almost in the middle, now we're in the point where we make two single crochets together, we work also two single crochets together. And and now in every stitch a single crochet. Work so all the way around, and in the beginning we make an invisible join. The yarn is back on the hook, and we begin here in the middle point of the bag, where we make two double crochet together, and we begin with a standing two single crochets together. The yarn is on my hook, and we enter the hook in that first two double crochets together in that stitch. Grab your yarn, pull up. Then go to the next stitch, the second two double crochets together. Go in, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over and pull through three loops. Now in every stitch we make a single crochet. And don't forget that little tail here. We work around that little piece of thread. In every stitch a single crochet. The last stitch is here. And we make the last single crochet in that chain two space, make also a single crochet, and now in every stitch all the way around a single crochet. Work so all your stitches all the way around here, and then we make the last stitch here on the last chain stitch, and then a single crochet in that chain two space, and then in every stitch a single crochet, and then we close with a slip stitch here in the beginning. The last two chain stitches, also a single crochet in those two stitches, and then we skip here that first single crochet. We make a single crochet in the chain two space, and then in every stitch a single crochet. I made my last single crochet, and now here in the top of two single crochets together we work a slip stitch. We go on, you make a chain, and in that same stitch a single crochet. And now you work all the way around in every stitch a single crochet. Work so all the way around. Make all your stitches and work in the beginning. Here in that first, not in that first stitch, but in the second stitch in a visible join. This side is ready now, and now we repeat all those stitches on the other side, and then we're done. And this is the end result of the bag. I hope you like this tutorial. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye!